topic today is about doing business in Cambodia, and I focus on the latest update and mainly about how to be compliant, how to do business properly, legally, and in a way that we say compliant business. What I will be sharing is mainly related to the Ministry of Commerce, Tax Department, Ministry of Finance and Economy, underlying ministries, and so on. I will focus on three key aspects. The first aspect is about what you should know before you register a company. Then I will share more about what you need to know to register your company properly. And the last aspect is about a must to know, something very, very important. If you don't know, there's an issue. What you must know after the registration is completed. This aspect is about what you should know before you start registering your company or before you kickstart your business incorporation. Yeah. And about types of businesses in Cambodia, and then I will talk about size of business in Cambodia. I will talk about why and when to register or to incorporate the business. We have segmented business into three aspects. The first aspect is about legal entity, or they call it company. Yeah, they call it company. So this one is more like a standard structure. So everything stands out on a piece of paper, and they will follow that. When you form a legal entity or legal company with the Ministry of Commerce, you can choose different forms. And when you see co-entity and enemies, that the company is governed by Article Incorporation. Yeah, it's the legal entity. This option is for one single owner. So if you register a company alone, you will go this option. This option is private limited liability company. The liability is the same, but the difference is you can have more than one shareholder. This one is for one owner, but this one is for between 2 to 30 shareholder. And the liability is the same, private limited company, okay, called LTD. This aspect is about the representative office. The legal structure is the same, company limited, private limited company, but representative office refers to, for example, you have your headquarters in the US, and you are now planning to kickstart in Cambodia as a representative office. You want the representative office has the right to research, you have the right to conduct research and feasibility study, your market assessment, and so on. You have the right to do the exhibition. You have the right to issue quotation, and maybe your headquarters can sell it, but you have no right to sell, you have no right to issue tax invoice. That's about representative office. You kickstart first, and then once you feel like, or you see that there is opportunity to go further, you convert to one of them. Subsidiary company. Subsidiary company is also a form of private limited company. Limited liability is the same, but subsidiary refer to a new company owned by another company. The company can be based in Cambodia, or it can be based abroad. It can be owned 100%, or maybe 80, 70, or 60, and so on. For example, you have a company in the US. I am a person. We can form one company together. It's a subsidiary, and you own 90%. The headquarters in the US own 90%. I own 10%. That's also a form of subsidiary, for example. Foreign branch in Cambodia. Some people, they think critically about their brand, because their brand is very well known, so they don't want to change their name. They want to repeat saying or advertising their name. So to ensure that they get it exactly the same name, they have to register it as a branch in Cambodia. For example, again about his company again in the US. For example, if your company in the US, the mother company is ABC. ABC LLC. Your company over there is ABC LLC. Then you register a branch here. Yeah. So it's going to be branch of ABC LLC. And this one is a little bit different. It's still limited liability, but not private, public limited liability. And normally it's for like corporate, like bank, like investment company, they put the share on sale as well. The last two is simpler, no article of incorporation. You can form a company as partnerships, which means company one, company two, company three form a new company together, or individuals. And this one is sole proprietorship. You want to kickstart a small business. You don't want to have limited liability, but this one, there is no bylaw, there is no registered capital. The more you spend, the more you lose, the more you pay. If you have no money in the bank account, you sell your car or your house to pay off. When you register a business with the Ministry of Commerce, these are the options you choose. Yeah. And the procedure, the paperwork is different.
Making it easy. Making Cambodia easy.